Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Myself Dr. M. Srujan Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Let us move on to the today's topic, that is identification test for emulsions. Before moving on to the identification test for the type of emulsions, first we will understand what do you mean by the term emulsions. Emulsions are thermodynamic unstable heterogeneous biphasic systems. There are two types of systems, one is monophasic, the other one is biphasic. When you say monophasic, a system that is having two phases, one is miscible with the other, it is also called as homogeneous system or monophasic system. What do you mean by biphasic system? A system that consists of two phases, one is immiscible with the other, it is also called as heterogeneous system or biphasic system. So here, why we are saying emulsions are unstable preparations? So let me give you an example. Take oil, little amount of oil, and add it to water and just mix it. So what is your observation? The oil is dispersed into the water as fine globules. Then this particular glass containing oil and water, leave it for some time undisturbed. So after some time, what is your observation? So here you can observe two layers, one is oil layer and the water layer. So this particular system is an unstable system. But coming to our formulation of emulsions, we need a stable system. So how you have to prepare a stable system? So that stable system can be prepared by adding a stabilizing agent called as emulsifying agents. When you add an emulsifying agent to the preparation, this emulsifying agent will make your oil globules dispersed into the water and it improves the stability of your emulsions. So here, next explanation, at least one immiscible phase dispersed as globules into the other liquid phase. As discussed now, above emulsion can be stabilized by adding an emulsifying agent. So what happens when you add an emulsifying agent? That unstable preparation will get converted into a stable preparation. This is about the definition of emulsions. Examples for the emulsions are oil in water type of emulsions, water in oil type of emulsions, oil in water in oil type of emulsions, water in oil in water type of emulsion. Next, we will move on to identification test for emulsions. So the first test here we are going to discuss is miscibility test or drop dilution test. So take a beaker and to that beaker add oil in water type of emulsion. To that oil in water type of emulsion, okay, add some water to it. So when you observe that there is no phase change, then you can confirm this particular emulsion is oil in water type of emulsions. So here there is an important thing, always these tests are confined to the continuous phase of the emulsion. So in any emulsion, as I said, there are two phases, one is dispersed phase, the other one is continuous phase. When you say oil in water type of emulsion, oil is a dispersed phase, okay, and water is a continuous phase. So to this oil in water type of emulsion, when you add little amount of water, that water will go and add it to your continuous phase. So ultimately there will be no phase change, okay. So when there is no phase change, you can confirm that this particular type of emulsion is oil in water type of emulsion, clear? Then to the same emulsion, add some oil to it. So on adding oil, definitely you can observe a phase change. Okay, when you observe a phase change, you can confirm that this particular type of emulsion is oil in water type of emulsion. Okay, so next situation. So you are taking water in oil type of emulsion. To that water in oil type of emulsion, now you are adding some oil. So we know that here oil is a continuous phase. When you add oil, what happens here? There will be no phase change. Then you can say that it's a water in oil type of emulsion. So when you add water to the same above, then ultimately you can observe what? a phase change. Then you can confirm that it is a water in oil type of emulsion. So considering this particular miscibility test or drop dilution test, the main thing that what you need to consider, what is the dispersed phase and what is the continuous phase. So when you have clarity on dispersed phase and continuous phase, easily you can identify which type of emulsion is that. Okay, so you don't know what type of emulsion it is. Take a beaker, take some quantity of emulsion to the beaker, add some water. Okay, so on adding water, if there is no phase change, then you can confirm that definitely it is a oil in water type of emulsion. To the same one, add some oil before adding water, add some oil to it. When you observe a phase change, definitely you can confirm that it is a oil in water type of emulsion. This is how you need to identify. This is one of the method. Okay. Yeah. Next, moving on to the next method. Moving on to the next test, that is fluorescence test. So we know that many oils show fluorescence when exposed to UV light. So here, how you are going to perform the test and how you are going to identify what type of emulsion it is. So in a beaker, take an emulsion called as water in oil type of emulsion. This water in oil type of emulsion should be observed under UV light microscope. So observing under UV light microscope, so if that entire beaker shows fluorescence, then you can say it as water in oil type of emulsions. So you don't know what type of emulsion it is. Okay, you have taken a small amount of emulsion and you have been observing under a UV light microscope. When the entire emulsion is showing fluorescence, then you can say that it is water in oil type of emulsions. Why? The same thing here, ma. So water is a dispersed phase. Your oil is a continuous phase. Okay, which is in larger quantity here? Your oil. So that's the reason entire that emulsion shows fluorescence. So you can say it as water in oil type of emulsion. In the next situation, you have taken oil in water type of emulsion. Oil is a dispersed phase. Water is a continuous phase. So what observing under your UV light microscope, what would be your observation? You can observe some spotty appearance of your oil droplets. Spotty appearance of oil droplets appearing in blue color. That is nothing but fluorescence color. So when you observe some spotty appearance of oil globules, you can say it as oil in water type of emulsions. When you observe the entire emulsion as a fluorescence, okay, you can say it as water in oil type of emulsions. Again, see, this test also confined to your continuous phase of your emulsion. Okay. Moving on to the next test, color test or dissolubility test. Here, for your understanding, I have quoted some examples for water soluble dyes and oil soluble dyes. Amaranth dye, tartrazine, erythrosine, etc. are the examples for water soluble dyes. Scarlet red, alizarin, cyanine green, etc. corresponds to your oil soluble dyes. So how we are going to perform the test? Take a beaker. To that beaker, add oil in water type of emulsion. When you say oil in water type of emulsion, here water is a continuous phase, oil is a dispersed phase. To this, add a water soluble dye. So the water soluble dye added is amaranth. So what is your expectation here? The continuous phase appears red. Why the continuous phase appears red? Because the continuous phase is water phase and the dye that has been added is a water soluble dye. So when you observe some red spots inside the emulsion, okay, then you can say that it is as a water in oil type of emulsion. Why? Here the continuous phase is oil phase and water is a dispersed phase. So water acts as a fine droplets dispersed into your continuous phase. So as this water droplets will take up the amaranth dye, so they appear as red colored spots. So moving on to the next situation, you have taken water in oil type of emulsion and you have added what? Oil soluble dye called as scarlet red. What would be your expectation here? The continuous phase appears red in color. Why? The dye added is an oil soluble dye and the continuous phase is oil. So when the same beaker, when you observe some red spots, okay, inside the emulsion, okay, then you can say it as an oil in water type of emulsion. So again, this oil acts as a dispersed phase into your continuous phase called as water, and the dye that you have been added here is an oil soluble dye, ultimately there will be an appearance of red spots in the case of your oil in water type of emulsion. This is about your color test or dye solubility test. Moving on to the next test, conductivity test. We all know that water is a good conductor of electricity. Now, how we are going to perform this test? We are going to perform this test through a simple assembly. Take a beaker, to that beaker add oil in water. So when you add oil in water type of emulsion, we all know that water is the continuous phase here. Okay, this is very important for every test. Okay, so in that beaker, place two electrodes, and these two electrodes are connected to a bulb through a wire. Okay, when the bulb glows, okay, you can say that that particular emulsion is oil in water type of emulsion. When the bulb does not glow, then you can say that that particular type of emulsion is water in oil type of emulsion, because here in the second case, oil is in continuous phase. Okay, it cannot conduct electricity. Okay, and in the first case, your water is a continuous phase as it conducts electricity. So this is a very simple test in order to identify the type of emulsion called as conductivity test. Moving on to the next test, cobalt chloride paper test. Two things we need to understand here. One is anhydrous cobalt is blue in color and hydrated cobalt is red in color. I repeat, anhydrous cobalt is blue in color, hydrated cobalt is red in color. Now, how you are going to perform this test? Take a filter paper and treat that filter paper with cobalt chloride solution. After treating filter paper with cobalt chloride solution, dry it. After drying, dip the dry treated filter paper in an emulsion, in an unknown emulsion. Okay. If you observe change of color from blue to pink, then it indicates oil in water type of emulsion. When you observe change of color from blue to pink, indicates oil in water type of emulsion. As I said the statement before itself, your anhydrous cobalt is blue in color. Your paper is blue in color now. When you dip this particular paper into the emulsion, okay, if the emulsion is oil in water, your water is a continuous phase, right? So your paper will get hydrated. When it gets hydrated, ultimately it will turn to a pink color. This is about your cobalt chloride paper test. When there is no change of color from blue to pink, then definitely you can say that it is a water in oil type of emulsion. I hope everyone got some knowledge through this topic called as identification test for emulsions. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel for more interesting videos. Thank you very much.